Good morning, friends. How are you? I hope you are keeping safe and healthy. Today, I'm here with a beautiful poem, Solitude, by Ella Wheeler Wilcox. It is an inspirational poem. Ella wants her readers to be cheerful, happy, and self-reliant. The poem comprises of 3 stanzas of 8 lines each, which is also known as octaves. I will read each stanza and then explain it. I hope you will all enjoy. So here we go. Laugh and the world laughs with you. Weep and you weep alone. For the sad old earth must borrow its mirth, but has trouble enough of its own. Sing and the hills will answer. Sigh, it is lost on the air. The echoes bound to a joyful sound, but shrink from voicing care. In this stanza, the poet says that if we laugh, the world laughs with us. You know, it is a known pronouncement that the world accepts or pushes away human emotions. The first 2 lines tells a reader that if you laugh, the world laughs with you, and if you cry or weep, they will leave you alone. The poet calls the earth sad and old and says that it also borrows happiness from us, as it is already overburdened with its own problems. The poet goes on to say that if you sing, even the hills will rejoice and answer back. But your sigh or any sound of worry will be lost in the air. Everyone wants positivity in life. People do not flock around negativity. So one should laugh and be cheerful, because even the earth will not accept us. The earth is already overburdened. It has got so many problems caused by man himself. So let us all be cheerful for each other and for the earth. Stanza 2. Rejoice and men will seek you. Grieve and they turn and go. They want full measure of all your pleasure, but they do not need your woe. Be glad and your friends are many. Be sad and you lose them all. There are none to decline your nectared wine, but alone you must drink life's gall. Here, in these next 8 lines of Solitude, the speaker or the poet presents another 5 statements that outline how the world at large reacts to positivity and negativity. The first line says that if you are to spend your days rejoicing, then others will seek you out and want to spend time with you. But if you grieve or cry, then the same men will turn and go. She also says that if you want to have friends, then you need to be glad, otherwise you will lose them all. In the last 2 lines, the speaker says that if you are happy and drink nectared wine, then you are never going to be short on friends to drink it with. Now, nectared wine here is a metaphor. Metaphor is a poetic device to compare two similar things. Here, nectared wine means all the celebrations and happy times. Moving further, the poet says that life's gall, that is, all the unhappiness, must be consumed alone. No one will be there when you are sad or unhappy. No one wants to burden themselves with any unhappiness or negativity. So always be happy. Always rejoice. Be cheerful. Be positive. Because you alone have to do everything for yourself. Third stanza. Feast, and your halls are crowded. Fast, and the world goes by. Succeed and give, and it helps you live. But no man can help you die. There is room in the halls of pleasure for a large and lordly train. But one by one, we must all file on through the narrow aisles of pain. Here, the speaker presents her final set of comparisons. You must have noticed that from the beginning, she has been comparing two different things. Now here she begins by utilizing another comparison to the way meals can bring people together. If one was to hold a feast or a party or a celebration, then their halls would be crowded. But if one fasts, then the whole world would pass by. No one will be around. Welcoming community, companionship, and happiness is going to inspire even more of the same. At the end, she makes larger statements about life and death, and the way that humans deal with pain. She describes how success and a willingness to give will help one live a longer life. But there will be no one there when you die. Similarly, pain has to be faced alone. No one wants to pile onto a train that is headed for that kind of unhappiness. The world would gather much in the hall of pleasure. So, here the poet means to say that when you are happy, you are giving, you are cheerful, people will flock around you. But during pain and death, no one wants to be there with you. You will be left alone. So it is better to stay happy, to be cheerful, to be self-reliant, because we ourselves have to solve all our problems. We ourselves have to shoulder our burdens. No one will be there to help us. So be self-reliant and be cheerful. Theme of the poem. The main theme is the cruelty of humanity. When you are in a joyful mood, people want to keep your company since they want a share of happiness. However, if you are snow-cast and gloomy, people tend to avoid you due to their desire to avoid pain and seek happiness. The world is like an echo which responds and resounds to happiness. When there is sadness and melancholy, solitude is the only thing you are left with. So stay positive, cheerful, and self-reliant. I hope you all liked this poem, Solitude, by Ella. I hope you are going to read the poem, see the video again and again for proper understanding, and come back to me if there is any problem. Thank you. Do take care of yourself. Friends, if you have not subscribed to my channel, now is the time. Please like, share, and subscribe.